My name is Maggie Johnson. I'm a postdoctoral fellow with MarineGEO. I'm here with the MarineGEO field campaign to study how reefs are growing in different places in Belize and in different parts of the Caribbean. And I'm using a standardized metric that fits well into the MarineGEO monitoring program. And I've had some monitoring tiles out for the last 2 years, and I'm starting the third year of data collection and deployment. So I'm here to collect the tiles that I put out last year and set up another set of tiles that I'll come back a year from now and check on.
Can you show us what the tiles look like before and after?
Yes. So here are the tiles that I'm working with. We refer to these as calcification accretion units, or CAUs, because we use them to estimate how much calcification or how much calcium carbonate production is happening on a coral reef. And they're paired settlement tiles that basically act like mini condominiums, mini apartments, so that when we put these on the reef, we get a whole suite of animals and plants that settle on them and grow. And by deploying the same type of tiles in different sites and in different places, we get a standardized metric for how much calcium carbonate production is happening on these different reefs. And so this is what it looks like when we start out. When we come back a year later and look at those tiles after they've had a whole year to grow and to incubate different creatures, we see something that looks like this. And of course, this is going to look different depending on the site that you're working on. Here in Belize, we see that a lot of the tiles are covered by crustose coralline algae, particularly on the top here. But then if you look on the inside, this was in that protected cryptic space. We got all kinds of other critters, bryozoans. We see some shellfish growing on some of them. And on the bottom tiles, we also tend to see a lot of coral recruits or baby corals that have settled onto the tiles. Crustose coralline algae are important for a variety of reasons. They are essentially the glue or cement for a coral reef. So if you think about a coral reef as almost like Swiss cheese or porous, and it's made up of all of these different rocks and boulders and pieces of rubble, the crustose coralline algae grows as a crust over these surfaces that are discontinuous and basically cements them all together. It stabilizes the reef matrix. And in addition, it's also contributing to active reef growth. And another important role that they serve is by producing chemical cues that induce settlement in coral larvae. The cool thing about these tiles is that we do get an idea for how the ecosystem is functioning, because calcium carbonate production is essentially the foundation of the ecosystem. So think about it as the three-dimensional structure, the framework. And in order to have healthy coral reefs that are persisting over time, those reefs need to continue building and continue growing. And so these tiles give us a metric that tells us how much calcium carbonate production is happening, at least in terms of the coral and algae, how much settlement is happening with the corals. And it gives us kind of a baseline that we can monitor over time to see if that fundamental ecosystem property is changing over time. So with this particular data set, we're finding some really interesting patterns in how much carbonate accretion and what settles and grows in these tiles in different places. So on reefs that are heavily impacted by human activities, particularly local sources of pollution, nutrient runoff, sedimentation, fishing, those sites look very different and function very differently than other sites that are a little farther away from those local point sources of pollution, like we have here in Carrie Bow Cay. That's a little bit farther offshore than some of the sites that I work on in Bocas del Toro, Panama. I'm hoping that we can use these data to give us a baseline metric to understand what our reefs look like now, and we can continue monitoring this in the future and understand how they're changing with changes in local coastal development as well as global impacts.